Yeah, we rolling.
It hit me that, hey man, Billy, first of all, you look amazing.
Hey man, I feel like I got to do one of them turns like this.
You should. Know what I'm saying? Billy.
What's the move we do?
Like dealers. That's I was just telling this nigga, people don't know it. Billy, what is that woke ass ashtray?
There he is right there.
Let me get this out of my mouth. Excuse me. Apologize, guys. I was telling Billy, Billy was asking me about dealers, and CC said, I don't understand why y'all clap off like that. What is that about? Well, the reason hold up. Hold the fuck up.
Mm-hmm. You know what she's about to do.
Ernest!
Yo, E!
Big Money E!
Yo, Big E!
Ain't that a bitch? Ernest!
Hey, E!
I say, yo, E!
Hey, E!
As you can see, E is not responding because Big Money E is on a money mission right now.
Big, I tried to tell y'all.
He out there getting the bag.
We kept trying to tell y'all he Big Money E now.
Here's the deal. I ran into him on the way into the studio. I ran into E.
Oh, did you?
He had a one of them, you know, them backpacks that they give, like a production crew backpack?
Yeah.
He had one of them on his chest. Mm-hmm. And I said, what's happening? Moving and shaking.
like we not recording tonight.
Like we don't have a show to do tonight. Moving and shaking. Yeah, man, they got me over here. The only thing about it is, let me tell you something. He likes his job. Yeah. Hey, Simo, he likes his job.
Yeah, he likes being in charge.
He said, the only thing is, this, you know, it's long hours and they keep you there. Other than that, you know, pretty much I'm calling the shots. See, he's still flexing.
I'm calling the shots. I'm calling the shots.
Hey, but hold up. We take it all. Goddamn, he's hey, man, we can drive a motherfucking car on three wheels.
Yeah, we can.
Because we make it look good when we drive it.
Who over there?
Simo!
What up?
Let me let you know something, playboy.
What's up with your boy?
What's up?
If you leave, the show's fucked.
The daddies have gone.
I'm going to let you know.
We already lost one daddy.
Hey, guys, let me tell you something, guys. These two guys are in control of the show. Make sure when me and Billy doing what we supposed to be doing. When we have shows on the road, they call and check on, make sure me and Billy ain't doing that wild. Because when me and Billy on the road, like January 3rd through the 6th in Arlington,
yeah,
it's going to be wild.
And they know it.
And everybody know it. So, Simo is here. Luckily, Simo.
We're a single parent home today.
If Simo caught the flu, God forgive, throw it out of the window. If he got sick.
Uh-huh. And said what?
How you gonna see us looking to fly?
You might not even see this one. I'm not gonna lie to you. We may not even see this episode.
Shit.
You know why I just thought about it?
Why?
Because Daddy E still gotta be on top of the edit to decide when it's gonna go up.
When it go up.
And if he don't like it.
It might not go up.
It might not go up. Quality
man,
control
we look
is high.
Too good for it now to go. Hold on, Simo.
It's gotta go up.
It's January 1st. We're gonna be in Dallas in 2 days. It's going up.
Goddamn right, 2 days. Let me tell you something. That's the beauty. Look how fast we record shit. We gotta get on a plane after this show.
Yeah.
And get out of here.
To come to y'all, January 3rd.
Flying right there to you.
Arlington, man, let me tell you something. He got money, and then he flexing it.
Yeah.
I never seen that backpack before.
Nah, let me tell you, man.
That's a new backpack.
Let me tell you, I tried to go in there the other day in this room. I go in there, it's new clothes everywhere. Scan it about. I said, oh, I see what's going on.
He got a stylist. Yeah. I knew what the fuck is going on. He got a stylist now.
Yeah. The boxes still stylist. Coming down. This FedEx.
They still got boxes?
They got FedEx to come pick up your package. That's what they got up there, a bunch of packages.
They've been here so much, now you got to go to them.
He's shopping. He giving shit.
He's shopping his ass off.
He getting little shit. He getting it.
What you see up there?
Hey, man, nigga got, three extra bottles of cologne, facial scrub.
You scrubbing your face now?
He got all type of shit in there, man. He got all type of shit in there. He low key.
He's scrubbing his face, man.
He got all type of different type
Wait
of scrubs.
Stop it. Stop. Simo.
Scented candles. The candle costs $15. I know it. That's expensive ass.
Niggas paying $15 for candles.
You got a whole caddy full of facial shit.
Shout out to Claudia. She make candles. I don't think your shit is $15. You could have got one from Claudia for $7.50. $15 goddamn.
You let me talk about Claudia up there in Seattle.
Mm-mm. She here. Right here. She down the street, as a matter of fact.
I need a candle, Claudia.
Claudia, yes, from El Salvador. She makes candles, some amazing candles. And he went out to. You know why he went out? Because he got a new outfit. You show your new outfit when you go buy a new candle.
You know why?
Everybody know you got money.
And you know what tonight is.
What is tonight?
It's New Year's Eve. And we going to party like it's 1999. We're leaving all that old bullshit behind. All that old bullshit behind. The shit that happened this year, fuck it.
Fuck all the shit that happened in 2018. Can I say something?
Go ahead.
I made a few bad decisions in 2018.
Mm-hmm. But you know what? It's not about what decisions you made bad. It's what you walked away from.
You're absolutely right. And I'm going to address it. I got to address it. Simo!
You.
Billy, could you pour me one of those shots of that? That would be so kind. If you'd be so kind.
You know what happened?
What happened?
A police officer was killed today.
They doing what?
Serving a high-risk warrant in Echo Park.
Pass me the bitch.
Mm-hmm, pass you the bitch. You go, here you go. Hey,
man, there you go.
Yeah, you see him?
As a matter of fact, if you could be so kind as to pour it, why?
Mm-hmm. He survived.
Mm-hmm. By who?
By his wife.
Uh-huh.
And an infant child.
That's right.
Shit gets deeper.
It has to.
Oh, it's going to definitely get deeper.
It has to get deeper.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it should. There it is.
Billy, I'm excited.
Mm-hmm. See that lighter?
You got it. I'm excited.
Now what you excited about?
I'm glad you asked. We have real fans in the show.
We don't just got fans. We got family. The show is a...
Fans, family of this show, Billy.
They just all about supporting us.
Yes, it is.
Everybody don't have that.
No, they don't.
It get rough when you don't have that.
And I just want to do a toast, Billy.
Okay. Put this in here for old Papa Poo-Poo.
Yeah, go and get that. Goddamn, Ernest got money.
Yeah.
Ernest got some money now.
Yeah, he definitely got some money.
That boy got money. I'm happy for you, Ernest.
Let me help you with that.
Go ahead. Ernest got that money, man. Hey, man. I'm gonna do this cheers and I'm gonna tell you something about 2018 real briefly that I'm a little apologetic about.
Can I give you a toast?
Yes.
This is for everybody at home if you wanna your glass up to this.
Come on, man, lift
Repeat it. After me. We gonna party.
Like rock stars.
We gonna fuck.
Like porn stars.
And we gonna come.
Like shooting stars.
Let's go.
Let's get
it.
It is. I'm all for it.
Yeah, it is.
I'm all for that. Billy, I kicked the Mexican in 2018. When I went on my trip with the lovely lady who was so kind enough to take me on the trip, I kicked the Mexican, and I want to say this because I didn't get a chance to apologize to that Mexican gentleman. Wherever you are in Puerto Vallarta, we're on the beach, I had 9 shots, I kicked you in the head. Luckily, I didn't get a clean shot, but I kicked you. And I want to say, had it not been for those shots, I probably wouldn't have kicked you. We kind of discussed it verbally. So, little Mexican man, wherever you are, I want to apologize for kicking you in the head. Again, I didn't get a clean shot.
Yeah.
However, I want to start my year fresh, renewed, and not living in 2018. I apologize, little Mexican man.
Mm-hmm.
Wherever you are.
You got to apologize to them. You know.
I feel better already.
Courtney and I was riding to the store. Went to the liquor store one night.
Mm-hmm.
And you know how it is when you're talking to your woman.
Yeah.
You get caught up in the conversation. And I was a little caught up in the conversation. So leaving the liquor store, I'm at the light, right about to turn in front of the house. And you know how you talking to somebody and you're not looking? Well, I'm at the light about to make a right-hand turn, and there's a crosswalk right in front of me. But I'm rolling through that, you know, to make that turn, it right on red turn. I'm doing what we call a bunny stop or a roll to red light. I didn't fully come to a complete stop. So as I didn't come to a complete stop, and I'm talking to Courtney and looking off, speaking of Mexican men, it was a little Mexican man on a bike, ran smooth over. I ain't talking about tap. He fell off his bike. I said, God damn shit. Courtney said, what happened? I hit a goddamn Mexican. So I got out the car. I'm looking for injuries on the man. He's getting up. And then when he sees me get out, I forget I got my chains out. He falls right down. Aye! Aye! Oi! 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 So now he done turned his ankle over, like his ankle dislocated. I cannot move it. I said, come on, man, move out there. I cannot move it. So I said, oh, this nigga doing this to me right now.
Bushing.
About to fuck my night up. So two cars stopped. Hey, man, you didn't see him? I said, look, I'm not gonna lie, I hit him. But it ain't shit wrong with his leg. Cause he turned his leg like this. He got his leg, he got his ankle turned over. Like, hey bro, I'm watching you. Your shit wasn't even hurting like that. So he's doing this. So he say something to the other little Mexican dude that came up out the car that was like going, hey man, you didn't see him? So he's he's gotta do something. We're just gonna wait on the ambulance. And you got your insurance? I said, he ain't got no car, we don't need no insurance.
Right.
I don't see a motor vehicle out here. That's cool, y'all wanna wait on that ambulance, that's cool. And so I'm like, man, the dude faking, man. He need to come on now.
Your boy Bush.
Now, you know, this ain't an ambulance situation.
Dude faking.
Hey! He's saying, you know, if you don't want the ambulance to come, you should.
He said, your dude faking.
Yeah. He said, now I'm gonna tell you what they're running on me. They're running a play. The play is try and get me for some money.
Some cash.
Well, you know, if you just don't want the ambulance to come and then to be a situation, why don't you just give him some money so he can do that? I said, oh, I tell you what, he wants some money. Let me help you out with that. There's a number you can call to get some money, whatever you need some money. And that number is
323-385-9734. We'll get somebody over there to you. Just hold tight,
even in the midst of an accident. So I hit him with that. And he was like, yeah, okay, but he needs money. I said, okay, let me help you with that money. I pulled my phone out. This is another number we can call. Called 911. Let's get a police officer over here because right I identify this goddamn Mexican. I say, hey, yeah, what's your name, brother? Police gonna be on the way. Might as well call the federal authorities too. Make sure they can verify that you a citizen. Oh no, it's okay. It's okay. I'm fine. He started limping off. I said, where you going, man? The police on the way too. That way we can identify everybody. The dude that was driving the car, he says, come on, man. That's a little bit mean. I said, hey, all's fair in love and war, especially in car accidents. You can play me, but you ain't gonna play me, goddammit. Right. That's cool. We can wait on the ambulance. We're gonna wait on that police officer too, so we can get that ID up out you. Right. So that way we can see that you supposed to be over here. And then got the fuck out of Dodge.
Yeah, right,
he got out of Dodge and disappeared. I went home. Me and Courtney got some shit started. I was about to get that thing popped off. Then she hits me midway. Wait. Before you get comfortable, can you go back and get some wine from the store? I said, you know how you got your plan, like, look, I done already drunk this liquor with you. Mm-hmm. Just go ahead, get naked, let's have sex, the kids asleep, and that way I can rest. Now you telling me to go back into the elements? Because that's what it feels like.
Right.
You want me to go back out into the world. Anything can happen out there, but you want to send me back out there for a bottle of wine or some champagne, whichever I can find.
About you.
And talking about,
well, do they, man, go do get the goddamn wine.
Some Moet or something? And tell you what, they ain't going to get back home is no goddamn Moet. I got some right. Corbell coming back for you. Some right. goddamn cooks. That's what the fuck coming back.
But I got some dick on me.
Dick on me.
That got dead on my pussy.
You can get that dick right now and don't right have to now. Worry about that.
Right.
I came back with some Andre. So I'm walking back to the house and in front of my gate, little Mexican man. He got his hat off, hat over his chest. He said, sir, money? In money for my leg? I cannot walk.
That nigga.
And I looked him dead in the eye and I said to him,
did you miss me? God damn it.
We took Happy New world. Year.
Welcome. Chop. Happy New Year, everybody, man. This is Did You Miss Me? I am D-Lay.
And I'm Billy Sorrells.
The hottest storytelling podcast in the game, man. And we're bringing the new year in with y'all, man. It's a beautiful thing, man. Billy, you look amazing.
Hey, man, I feel amazing.
God damn it, you look amazing, man. Billy, let me tell you something, bro. You got me to thinking, you made me change my whole direction. You talking about your wife. And I was thinking about my ex-wife, man. Shout out to my best friend, man. Lakia Laird. She still got my last name. It's my motherfucker, my son's mother, my best friend.
Hey, man, that's good. You know, even in, dog, the, in the man. Mr. Turmoil, that last name is a motherfucker.
Hey, man.
You know, me and Court was going through it earlier, so, you know.
She was thinking about getting the name out of there.
Yeah. Yeah, she was thinking about getting the name out of there.
Let me tell y'all, Simo, this is real shit, Simo.
What up?
This my dog. Hey. Man, I remember when we got a divorce, but we were still, like before the divorce was final, we were still talking shit. I was like, I'm thinking about getting two girlfriends. She was like, who are they? I was like, showed her a picture. She was like, okay, they're cute. Okay, well, I'm for it. like, whatever you want to do, whatever makes you happy. I was like,
that ain't what you wanted to answer.
That's my nigga.
That's the answer you wanted.
Hell yeah.
She was with it. She threw that thing.
It's my dog.
Now you out there, you living life.
Man, come on. Let me see what's going on. You know, man, the fuck I'm talking about. Hey, listen, I don't know what the fuck y'all doing with y'all life at home. This is 2019. Y'all better start fucking living in y'all truth. Stop fucking worrying about what somebody else think about you or how they feel about what you gonna do or what your next move gonna do. Fuck this. This is for you. Live your shit.
Didn't tell you, man.
You know how cool it is to have the freedom enough to talk to your ex-wife, your best friend, and be like, hey, this is what I'm going on. This was going on with me. And she opened up and shared and allow you to be who you are with no judgment. Man, step your shit up.
Ain't nothing wrong.
Fuck this whole lockdown, mentally lockdown shit. Some of y'all in relationships, the shit is unhealthy because you can't be who the fuck you want to be.
Man, you better get out there.
Open up.
Better go out there and be who you are you can be.
Which leads me to my ex-wife's birthday.
Oh, man.
Never forget it. Simo, I can't ever forget this, Simo.
Can't forget it?
I can't. Here's the deal, Simo, Billy. We're in Vegas. Ba, 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 ba! God damn it. I got the money, too, Simo.
Oh, you got it on your purse.
I got the money on my person.
Yeah.
I got it all over my person. I said, man, you know what? My wife turning 30. Mm-hmm. Simo, you got to go in for the 30th, Simo.
I had a breakup because shit didn't go right for the 30th birthday.
See what I'm talking about? Hey, on some real shit. The 30th is really that real.
I'm telling
you. You got to come with it for the 30th.
Yeah.
If you don't have it, you better fucking find a way to get it.
Yep.
It's her 30th. I know what it is. I'm working at the Wynn. I got my VIP company. Doing a little bit of comedy. Comedy is like, I get to you, nigga. You ain't really bringing no bread in. I love you. Ooh, but I got this other shit I'm doing.
Yeah.
So I said, you know what? It's time to turn up. Now, what I remember specifically about this turn up is a few days before I fucked up with my wife. Mm. I came in a little bit late.
Yeah.
So I said, oh, shit. And she was on my ass about it. Out with the fellas, getting drunk, getting lit. I'm in Vegas doing some dealer shit because I got money.
Yeah.
If you don't know nothing about me at this point, I got money.
Yeah.
I got a lot of motherfucking money.
Oh, that
quarter of a million, nigga. I got it.
Oh, that good money to buy.
Oh, and all the way to D.C. where they burn the money. That's where I'm at with it. I got it, Billy.
Well, Uncle Sam, something else, Eddie.
What you got?
Yeah, hey.
Billy, I said, listen. I'm going to do it big. I hadn't fucked up quite, you know, a few nights before. Her birthday's coming up. So let me tell you what I did. Billy, you want to know what I did?
What you do?
I'm glad you asked. Billy, do a cheers real quick because I'm going back to my wife's birthday. Man, March 1st, she's a Pisces. She's my motherfucker. Billy, first thing I do, I go shopping for her.
Mm-hmm.
I go buy a bunch of dope dresses. You know what I mean? I know where I went. The reason why I went, because the night before I fucked up, I knew I was gonna be fucking up by staying out too late. I told Billy about this. I said, hey man, sometimes you gotta have some fuck up money. You gotta get some buyback money, because you gotta get that time back that you done fucked up this woman's mind and her mental and her whole state of being. You gotta get that. Fellas, you gotta lay it down sometimes. Sometimes you gotta sprinkle some shit about, I'm not telling you to fuck up, I'm just saying if you are, sprinkle some shit that can pad that goddamn blow that you gonna give her, being coming in late, not necessarily cheating, I mean, coming in late, didn't do something that your lady asked you to do, that type of thing. I was going to Caesar's Palace this night because we were going to opium, me and Jay Reed, and I got money.
Mm-hmm.
On my way into the Caesar's Palace, I stopped in the Grand Mall. The Grand Mall, I stopped in the Gucci store. Bought my wife some Gucci shoes off the rip. Ain't nothing to talk about.
That means because you fucking up.
I already know where I'm at with it.
This ain't the first time you done this.
I got this. I know what this is. And the Gucci purse. That was $4,500 off the rip. Them two things. Who the fuck worried about it, Simo? I got money.
Got money.
It's her birthday.
And it's on my person.
Mm-hmm.
So what I said, you know what? Fuck it. This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to go in this goddamn casino. Yeah, I'm about to go into this club, party for a little bit, leave out halfway, win that 45 back that I lost right there, be on my merry way. As luck would have it, I go into the spot, do what I do, I party, have a good time, yada, 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 bam, leave there, go back into the casino, gamble, win 5,000 a night. I remember, it's like a $500 win night for me, right?
Yeah.
But everything else is free. Take the $500, me and my buddies go to the strip club.
Yeah.
This is the night. I'm backing this whole story up. I'm Quentin Tarantino on this thing for y'all. I'm backing this bitch up before I bring you the actual story. So I'm out there partying, having a good time in the strip club. I throw that $500 in the strip club, have a good time. Bam, get lit, go back home. Late night for me, going back home. Wife is mad. Couple of days, her birthday's coming up. Mm-hmm. Birthday night, I got all this shit in my car. I got a Lexus LS 460. Mm-hmm. It's sapphire blue. Peanut butter insides. Uh-huh. It's brand new. It's brand new. I can't remember what year it was, but whatever year it was, the year wasn't even in.
You was ahead of the year.
Whatever the year was, it wasn't even in, nigga. That's how new my shit is. I rode around with the plates, the tags on my shit.
Drive out tags.
For 2 months to let you know it's still new, bitch.
It's still new all the way to the next year.
Y'all don't have the year in yet, and I got the car.
Yeah.
I'm balling, nigga.
You just up here just the year before.
I'm the year before with my shit.
You got a time machine.
I take all the stuff that I got. It's all in my car. It's in the trunk. She don't drive my car. At this point, I ain't bragging, y'all. I'm balling. I got a Lexus LS 460. I have an Escalade Cadillac truck. I don't even drive. I just wash it.
Just washing that thing.
I don't even drive it. I just wash it so it looks good in front of my house.
Yeah.
That's what I do.
Just park that thing right out there.
Then we got the family car, which is a Ford Explorer, where my wife takes the boys around to different shit. You know what I mean? You gotta have that car, that kind of car.
Yeah.
We just balling, Billy. So I got all her shit in the back of the trunk in the LS 460, right? She's upset, and I apologize to her, and you know, her wife, you don't want to fuck with you for the next couple of days. She don't want to fuck you, and you don't want to force a fuck. It's kind of like, it's kind of subtle, but her birthday's coming up, but I'm kind of spicing it up. You know what I mean? Your birthday coming up, what you got for your birthday? I don't know, me and the girls probably do something, right?
You just got them Gucci shoes and that purse in that goddamn trunk.
She has no idea.
Yeah.
Billy, it's her 30th birthday. Gotta do it big. Her friend name is Erica. She said, I'm gonna call Erica, you know, cause she don't have a whole lot of friends. I ain't want my wife to have a whole lot of friends. That's how a whole lot of shit starts. Having a whole lot of friends.
Yeah.
You don't do all that. When you my lady, you might have one or two friends. And if that's the case, these are relatives, but they're not in our shit. But you're gonna be close to me because that's who you're dealing with. You don't marry to your family, you fucking with me. So to keep the bullshit down, I didn't want my wife to have a whole bunch of friends. Mm-hmm. So yeah, me and Erica can have a couple of girls around. We gonna probably, you know, have some drinks, whatever. Cool. Yeah. I know you got me something. You ain't slick. I was like, man, shit, I was thinking about getting you a card or something. You know, fucking, I ain't gonna run a card, right? So I can see she's loosening up. Mm-hmm. But what she doesn't know is, Simo, I've gone to the Palazzo Hotel. Mm. The Palazzo Hotel. Because I've got a membership at the 4040 Club.
Mm. Oh.
I got money, y'all.
You got a lot of money.
I got money all on my person. I got money. And sometimes I would just walk around with money in my boot. I had boots on. Just money in my boot. I don't
money
even go
just,
down there.
Just,
I don't even go down there till the end of the night when I'm taking them off. I just got money.
Money just all over there.
I got money. It's all over my person. So, Billy, I go to the Palazzo and I'm a 4040 member. I'm a platinum member, too. I'm a platinum. When Jay-Z was yelling it out, nigga, I had the card. Mm-hmm. So I give my wife a table. At the club at the Palazzo. Mm-hmm. The club at the Palazzo is going to be the pop. It's her birthday. Her shit is on a Saturday night. It's going to be the most pop night in Vegas. The shit is going down. Nas was performing tonight.
Oh, man.
It's going down. We shining. I go in there. I drop 10 racks for the table and the whole thing that come with the table for my wife. Bow. That came with a birthday cake, 5 bottles. Mm. Birthday cake, 5 bottles of whatever the choice was.
Oh, man.
Couple of vodkas, some champagne, some Hennessy's. Just a bunch of different bottles, right?
Yeah.
big, you know, sparklers and shit. It's a really
it's
big cake.
It's an extravaganza.
It's an extravaganza. I didn't drop that 10 on it.
Ooh, 10 riggities.
Nobody's worried about the 10, Billy. I got money.
Like,
I got money.
Much
man.
Like somebody else we know that got money.
Big money, money E. Oh, he got
yeah,
money.
He got money.
Big money E got the money, too. I'm in his position at this point.
Yeah.
Man, I'm like, I'm excited, right?
Yeah.
So, the reason why this is so familiar in my head as I think about it.
Any more weed over there?
I keep.
Just pass it while you're talking. I'm with you.
I keep weed and money, Billy. I keep it. I got it on my person.
Yeah, I know you.
Hold it right there. We can load up another one. Mm-hmm. So, Billy, I'm excited.
Mm-hmm.
So, I remember the day of my wife's birthday, I went to the trunk. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And I brought the dresses. I had like 5 dresses, nice dresses.
Now
I know my
up.
Fucking little bullshit ass was like really nice fucking dresses. Right? But then I just kind of set it on the bed, right? I said, good morning, happy birthday, right? Boys come in the room, happy birthday, mom. Everybody happy, oh, thank you, right? Give them a card, you know, from the boys. Everybody happy. And, you know, she don't see the shit on the bed until she go downstairs, come back up. Come back up, she sees it, she was like, oh my gosh, thank you. This is, oh, this is, oh my God. Oh, this is, this, you picked this yourself? Oh my God. She's giving all those emotions. I'm like, I'm winning like a motherfucker.
Cause she you don't even know.
You don't even remember how late I came in the other night. That's how much this shit feels to you. I am back. She don't know that. I got them Gucci shoes though. She was like, I'm gonna wear these shoes, I'm gonna wear these shoes, right? I walked upstairs, I put the bag down right in front of what the dress she was wearing, because I knew what dress I wanted her to wear, because she kept coming out. She changed 5 times for me just to see me in her shit. I said, wear that. I don't know if I had a shoes where, I was like, you can find some shoes in there. She's in there looking for shoes, she come back out. The Gucci shoes just sitting there. Tan Gucci. She said,
yeah.
Oh my God. She hadn't opened it yet. She opened the box and matched her dress. She said, oh my God. She started crying.
Oh man.
I'm like, I'm killing this shit, nigga. I'm killing this shit, Simo.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm like, nigga, this is dope. Because I love birthdays, because my birthdays used to be so fucked up. I just love celebrating people's birthdays.
He warmed my heart to hear what
like, when this nigga was in on his December 1st in Seychelles, I was like living vicariously. I was like, man, that's my motherfucking first. This is dope. So I'm big on birthdays, so I like to do that for people on their birthday. So she has no idea what's in store, right? So I said, listen, let's just go out, right? Tell Erica to meet us at the Palazzo. She was like, oh, okay, cool. Erica, she brings her man to the Palazzo, right? We get in front, people walk up. Now keep in mind, niggas know me in Vegas.
They know you.
I'm in this motherfucker. I invited all my friends, a couple of my fellas, Jay Reed, his wife. We walk up in that thing. She was like, what's going on? I was like, oh, I just got us a little table for the night. She was like, all right, cool. We all walk in there at her table. Big ass cake, happy 30th birthday, Kia. All balloons and shit. She was like, oh my gosh. She's like, she's looking at me, I'm like, hit another home run.
You're knocking him out the park.
I'm killing this
you
shit,
Jose
Billy.
Jose Canseco right now. You knocking
him out
the park.
I am Mark McGuire in this goddamn thing.
Mm-hmm.
So, all our friends around, right?
Yeah.
You know, everybody's looking like, who the fuck are they? We got money.
Yep.
That's who they are. We in there having a good time. And my wife ain't no jealous wife. Other women in there. Bunch of, it's some baddies in that bitch. Don't you ever make no mistake. It's some baddies in that bitch. Right? Yeah. So we having a good time. My wife is getting showered. They bring the bottles.
Uh-oh.
It's a fucking show. Nigga, they playing, mm-mm, go. Go, 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 shorty. It's your man, we tight in this bitch.
Y'all partying it.
We partying, nigga. They bring all the bottles. She looking at me like, oh my gosh, this is so dope, right? They put the bottles down. Everybody's having a good time. My wife looked at me, she said, look over there. I was like, I think I know what she looking at. She was like, she looking at you real hard. My wife is open. She ain't finna let, you know, ain't no, why that bitch looking at you? She was like, she looking at you real hard. I was like, go get her. Cool. Go get her, come back. Bad little thing. Bad little Spanish thing.
Making my dick jump.
Oh, my God. Samo.
Yo.
Bad. That night, my wife was wearing a tan dress, like a fitted dress, right? With like a lighter tan, stripe across with the Gucci. The chick had on a red dress, sort of like my wife's, but like cut a little higher. I said, okay, this is dope. My wife ain't tripping. She having fun talking to other friends. She says, come over here and dance with my husband.
God.
Simo.
You grooving it?
Oh. I'm in that motherfucker doing what Boo Pop, Boo Capone taught Pop.
The roll.
I'm in that motherfucker hey, bro, I'm having a good time.
Yeah.
The girl stays over. I bring her back over to the wife. He was like, hey, introduce yourself. Hi. Bam, they chopping it up. I'm like, cool. Hey, man, let's go ahead and cut this cake. Get the waitress over there. You know, let's do a toast to my wife. Cut the cake up, do a toast to my wife. Hey, man, to my wife, man. It's your 30th birthday. I told you when you first met me, I was gonna give you the world. And I ain't through giving it to you yet.
You ain't a real husband if you ain't said it. When you shine, you say you give him the world.
Hey.
It may not even be big shit to somebody else.
You get that, but hey, it's big to you. As long as you hold your glass up high enough. If you hold your glass up high enough, it says something.
Hey.
Hey, I'm gonna give you the world. Yeah. Hey. And I ain't through giving it to you yet. Bam. Everybody, clap. Man, having a good goddamn time. Now, at this point, it's about 3 a.m. All the liquor is damn near gone. On top of the shots that we're taking, they send me another bill. The bill's like $2,600. I don't know why I have a $2,600 bill. Because I got five bottles. I already spent 10 racks. What is going on? Well, let me tell you what's going on. See, when you're big timing like that,
yeah.
What happens is, other motherfuckers come by, and whoever your waitress is, they just order shit and be like, yeah, put it on that nigga right there. Yeah, I'm with them. So that goes on and on. But here's the deal. It's $2,600. Now, I don't want to pay it.
Yeah.
But I got money.
So you're going to pay
it. I got money.
Yeah.
So I said, man, fuck, it's $2,600. So the little chick, right, she was like, hey, what are you guys going to do? So my wife is lit. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I know where she at. So I said, you know what? Ain't no sense of me trying to throw that in the mix like that. It ain't gonna be right.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Ain't no sense of trying to mix this whole thing up. Wife in here, right? That's the most important thing. Let's get her home. Hey, shorty, I'm about to catch you on the other end.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It was nice partying with you.
See, sometimes you gotta know. You gotta know when
sometimes
to hold
them. Sometimes you gotta know.
When to hold them, when to fold them.
And know when to fold them. Know when to walk away. You better know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. Don't do it.
See, that's counting your money. When you do that,
you count your money.
When you got your wifey on deck and then you try and pull another one in there on a night when it's her birthday, hey. It's all about her that night. Now, she would have led with it.
If she'd have led with it,
yeah.
Then you roll with that.
Yeah.
But she's incapacitated.
And you know, if you want to know exactly how mm-hmm. to know when it's time to have a menage with your wife
mm-hmm.
or the woman that you're dealing with,
that's right.
And you're not sure if it's the right time or not, and you in question,
yeah.
Give us a call.
323-385-9734. We'll get somebody over there to you. Just hold tight. Somebody's gonna come to you. So man, I ain't gonna lie to you. Man, I didn't wanna let that night go. Mm. That red thing was on fire.
Oh man, I feel.
I didn't even see it first.
D, I feel like, keep going, bro.
I didn't even see it first. So I said, God damn. But I gotta be responsible. Most important thing is wifey and her safety, getting her to the crib. Cool. Deuce the shorty out. Get in the car, coming to valet. I got wifey, bam. Get in the car, we're rolling. We're rolling down Las Vegas Boulevard.
Mm.
I looked over at her and I saw her, she had her head back. And the windows was down and the breeze was hitting her and it was letting her hair blow. And I looked at her and I felt good because I said, man, this was great. I really did this motherfucker big.
Mm-hmm.
for my wife's birthday. It's her 30th. All her friends came out.
Yeah.
It was all about her.
You glowing.
I feel good.
Yeah.
Right? She got her head out. Right? The music is playing. And it's probably about 5 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
It's about 5 in the morning. And I said, man, I'm gonna get home, make sure she get to bed safe, and we're gonna talk in the morning about this. This is good. Head still in the wind, right?
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, I'm driving, and she says, so how was your night? I was like, hey, babe, I thought you was out, I thought you was asleep.
Wait.
No.
She asked you about your night.
She just popped up, Like the liquor, like, she had a burst of it.
A burst
she
of
said,
energy.
So how was your night?
That's called the spirit.
The spirit?
Yeah, that's called the spirit.
Okay. All right, cool. I said, all right, well, you good? You all right, babe? She was like, yeah, I guess.
And you know what? We're going to tell you more about what happened with that.
We got to.
Right after our break from our sponsors.
Yes.
We'll be right back. More Did You Miss Me right after this.
Hey, man, Billy, listen. This episode, we got to thank our sponsors, brother. And we couldn't have done it without them. There's no way we could have done it without them. Hollywood Bartenders, Inc. I want to thank our girl, LJ, over there for sponsoring this episode of the show by bringing in some beautiful Tito's vodka. LJ, we appreciate what you're doing. Shout out to Haiti. Sapase. Oh, bullet. Okay, all right, cool. Shout out to Haiti.
So, I know exactly where you are in this mm-hmm. moment. For those of you at home that don't have a wife or a woman in your life that drinks a lot, it's a point to where they're having a good time. They turned on. They feeling sexy. Then they feeling sexy, then they just trying to survive and stay alive through the night. Then it's a point when they're so drunk that they don't think that they're alive and they out of there.
Yeah.
That's when they kind of go all the way out. They hit them deep sleeps. They pass out in blackouts, don't remember nothing.
Yeah, don't remember that, yeah.
And most people think that's it, because you know, most people throw up right there.
Mm-hmm.
But when your woman is a professional.
She do this.
When she does this, there's another space. It's like, you know how they tell you miles to empty on your car? Mm. You got 7 miles to empty, you get to zero. In some cars, you get all the way to zero, you keep driving, and that bitch flips over, and some more miles pop up back there. That's them miles that you didn't know was there.
You didn't even know it was there.
You know the miles over? Those is called spirit. That's the spirit that is now why they call it liquor and spirits. And this spirit is whatever the fuck decides to come up. It's a crackerjack box. It's full of surprises. It's you never know how that's going to turn out. And if they're a little bit crazy, that's when that spirit pops up in them.
Yeah.
And now that spirit is driving. This person is done. This is a whole different person.
This is not the same person.
This is not your Kia at all. This person ain't see them Gucci shoes. They didn't see them $10,000 for the section. They damn sure didn't see the shit for the brunch and lunch.
No.
They didn't see the 25 that you spent on the bill.
26,
yeah. They didn't see none of that. They didn't see them five dresses you had laid out across the bed.
Nobody saw that.
They didn't see the card that you got them that said, Kia, you a good mom and a good wife. And you
know, that had money in it too.
Yeah, that had money in it. They didn't see you having a good time when she walked the woman over to dance with you. Because Kia did all that. This is somebody different. That is
a whole nother
evoked
person.
Evoked your wife's body at this point. And she jumps up and what does she do?
She says, glad you had fun tonight. Who? Who you talking? What's up, babe? Don't think I'm crazy.
Oh, man.
Oh, my gosh. What are you talking about? Don't think I'm crazy and I don't know. Now we driving down Las Vegas Boulevard. I remember specifically. Yeah. I seen it.
You saw what?
The bitch gave you her number. I said, yeah, she did, and I wasn't trying to hide anything. I was gonna give you her number. As soon as we got to the crib and you were, you know, in a space where you understand. Right.
Oh, man.
I'm like, okay, you know what? Maybe I shouldn't have taken the number, but I had no intent on dealing with this girl. I was gonna forward all this stuff to her. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I know the energy was all there. I'm just,
you were just,
and I don't want nothing. I'm good.
Oh, man.
No, you know what? You always do that shit.
Boom.
She pushed the head. Whoa, this is violent. I'm about to fight. Your body tells you. This your body, violent. If you come from an environment where I'm like, this is violent. Right now I'm about to have a fight.
Yeah.
I said, hey, I'm driving. I don't give a fuck about this car. Wait a minute, you gotta care about the car. We're in it. I don't give a fuck about this car. Explain to me what you want with the bitch in the red dress. I was like, babe, I was just on a, you brought her to me. We was on a, you know what I mean? It was gonna be one of, yeah. So why you got a number? I said, because we were all vibing. I was gonna give it to you. I wasn't gonna try to hide anything. As you can look, I don't even have it saved. It's just the number in there. To be honest with you, babe, I don't even remember her name.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't trying to be, I don't want to hear that shit.
Oh.
I don't want to hear that shit. Now, at this point, now she's waving her hand in my face.
You got to be careful, because once they do that.
Because let me tell you something. I don't want to get punched. I do not want to get punched. I'm like, you know what? I'm trying to just, you know, I'm trying to drive and watch this motherfucker. And she hit me with that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because this is the last time you play with me on my birthday. I just turned 30. And this shit that used to go on in my 20s. She giving me that speech. Oh. That used to go on in my 20s. Is not about to go on no more. And the shit stops. Now, DeVatric.
Boom. You ain't been 30 a hot 45 minutes.
You just got 30. And you lit.
You don't know shit about 30.
Nigga, we driving down the street. So I said, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just keep quiet until I get off Las Vegas Boulevard, get onto the 215, and get her home.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. I'm not gonna say nothing. I'm riding. She jaw jacking like a motherfucker. Yeah. Cause every time I look up, it's this new bitch. It's that new bitch. This new bitch. Oh, we working together. Oh, we about to work together. You think I'm fucking stupid?
Every time I look up,
I'm like, oh my
is
God.
This new bitch.
I ain't saying nothing.
That new bitch.
I ain't saying nothing. I'm still riding. Oh, so now I'm talking to my motherfucking self. You know what? Grabs the wheel, whips that bitch. Bow! I crash into the fucking curb, crack the fucking the cylinder. I'm like, oh my gosh. Keep in mind, now this is what I have not added to this story. I've been drinking like a motherfucker. I'm lit, but my wife is litter. She way litter. I said, oh my gosh. She crashed the car. I'm like, what the fuck did you do? She's still going in. You want that bitch. You want that bitch. I'm like, you just wrecked the fucking car. What are you doing? No, you want that bitch. You want that bitch. I'm like, what the fuck? Right, I get out the car. I'm looking at the car. The wheel is crushed. It's like turned almost parallel to the concrete. I'm looking at the car. It's cracked. Some people are running around. We on Las Vegas Boulevard, nigga, in Las Vegas. Somebody see this? We out there, and it's a store. Because we're right by maybe Sahara Boulevard.
Yeah.
It's a store up there, right? So I'm looking like, what the fuck? I go to the side of the car, right?
Yeah.
Gotta fucking lift the car door up, right? I open the door, I'm like, the fuck did you do? She was like, oh my gosh, I can't believe, she's a whole nother person.
That switched.
She done switched again.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, I can't believe it. She get out of the car, oh my gosh, she's crying. I'm like, bitch, you caused all this.
It's all your fault.
I go into the liquor, the store, whatever the store that it is, right?
Mm-hmm.
I was like, you know what? I said, ma'am, can I get, I don't know what I went in there for, right? I come back out, the police are there. I'm like, oh my gosh.
Your perfect night.
Oh my fucking gosh, my perfect night is going to, police is there. It's a lady officer and a man.
Oh man.
I'll never forget, I gave this woman so much shit that night.
Mm.
When I get drunk, I'm a little belligerent. I don't care who you are, especially the law. And this is thing.
Yeah.
This is before they were shooting niggas though. They wasn't really shooting niggas like this.
Yeah.
She was like, have you been drinking? I was like, yes, I have.
How'd you say it?
Yes, I have. wife's sitting on the curb.
That ain't some shit you saying.
Mm-mm.
If you drive it.
Mm-mm. My wife is sitting on the curb, right? Just crying. The other officer over there talking to her. How many drinks have you had, sir? I had two. I had two drinks. Do you recall what the drinks was? Absolutely, I do. Long Island iced tea. I didn't really finish the second one.
Okay.
So you had two Long Island iced teas. No, ma'am, I said I had two, but I didn't really finish the second one. Okay. All right, come over here for a second. Keep in mind, I am reeking of alcohol. I smell like a saloon.
Because you had five bottles.
On top of the $2,600.
Yeah.
That bill. But I'm not tripping because I got money. So I said, you know what? I remember my lawyer telling me how to get out of this.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to Garrett Ogata. If you're in the jam, he'll get you out. Garrett Ogata I met in a casino, and he already told me a list of things you can kind of say to the cop to get you out of taking a sobriety test.
Yeah.
So I said, all right, cool. Locked in. Got that. Here we go. Run it. You had two drinks, sir? Yeah. I want to take you to a few sobriety tests. All right. Could you put your hand on your nose? Bam. Look to left or right? I won't look left or right. Could you look left or right? I can't. Why can't you look left or right, sir? I just had eye surgery. Can't look. I don't want to strain that. I don't want to look to my peripheral. You had eye surgery? Yeah. And you're driving? Yes, ma'am. I've been okay to drive. But that could strain my eye. Okay. Okay. All right. Okay.
Can you follow my finger?
Here we go.
Can you follow my finger, sir?
Here we go.
Why can't you do that?
Can't do that. Just had eye surgery.
Okay.
Can't do that. Okay, sir, here we go. This line right here. I want you to do this right here. One after the other, I want you to follow this one straight line and just walk this line. I can't. Why can't you? I just had Achilles surgery. I hate to try to walk this line on an Achilles surgery.
I pulled out the Achilles and I got pulled over.
You pulled out the Achilles?
I did the same thing.
On everything, I'm running this down to this one. I can't do it. I can't do it.
Got Achilles.
I got an Achilles surgery. Okay. Not a problem. I need you to blow into this breathalyzer. I can't. Just had throat surgery. I want to blow into this breathalyzer. Strain my throat. You know what, sir? Are you refusing this? No, I'm not refusing. I'm just telling you I had surgery and it hurt me to do that. You know what, sir? And you're under arrest. You're refusing to take the drug test and we're going to draw blood. My wife. Shut up, bitch. It's your fault.
Yeah.
Get locked up. They impound my car.
Mm.
My car is fucked up. It's drivable, but it's impounded. It's fucked off. Backing the story up just a tad bit, while we're driving down Las Vegas Boulevard, prior to my wife grabbing the steering wheel and whipping that bitch, she grabs my wallet, throws that bitch clean out the window. That's gone too. Wallet gone prior to the bam. Forgot about that. Bam, wallet gone. I'm in jail, but I got money. I got some money, Billy.
You got some money.
Man, I said, call Garrett Ogata. Call Garrett Ogata now.
Yeah.
His office isn't open. That ain't his office number. That's his cell phone number, and it should be on his person.
Right now.
Run that! Garrett Ogata came and got me out of jail right away. Right away. Bam. I remember catching a taxi to my crib. I didn't go to my crib first. Yes, I did. Went to my crib first, got the other car.
Mm-hmm.
Told wifey, get in the car with me. Let's go. You do what the fuck I say at this point. I just went to jail for you.
Because you fucked around.
Get your ass, same party dress from last night. Keep that bitch on, get in the car. Let's go. We're going to the wrecker to get my shit been towed. I ain't got no ID. Nothing. I got nothing. I walk in there. Hey, I'm the owner of this vehicle. I can tell you everything that's in it. You have your ID? I don't have my ID. I lost my ID. Sir, you need your ID for us to do it. Ma'am, that blue car, that sapphire blue, it's mine. I can get you, which, sir, there's nothing we can do. You won't be able to get out without a license. Mm-hmm. All right, cool. Walked outside, I seen a guy outside. Looked like he was kind of working the yard. He was kind of moving cars in there, right? I looked over there, I seen him. I told my wife, I said, I'm gonna get that goddamn car out of there. Mm-hmm. You ain't got your ID. All right. I said, I'm gonna show you something. Take the car, leave me, go. She was in the Escalade, took the car, gone. She went back home. I woke up to the guy, say, listen, that's my car. That car is mine.
Yeah.
I need to get that car out of there. I don't have my ID, but I promise you, if you go open the door, he said, I said, but don't even try. I got the key. I had the key on me. I said, I'm gonna do you one better. How much you make a day?
Oh man.
I'm in Vegas, I got money. I said, don't even worry about it. I handed him, I counted out. Ain't nothing like counting money out in front of somebody.
Cash
money, right there.
Cause you don't know how much of it's gonna be yours.
Right.
I pulled it out. I already knew I was gonna have to come up with some cash. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Handed it to him. That motherfucker said, open that door, open that gate. I started my shit, drove the fuck off. You know who opened that door from the gate for me?
Who?
A Mexican. Shout out to the Mexicans again. That was my apology from the top of the show. Hey man, I fucks with the Mexicans.
Yeah.
That's who let me out. I gave that Mexican $500. He got my shit out there, bro. And guess what? A Mexican fixed my goddamn tire.
And got you back right.
Back in that bitch.
Got you back fucking right. It's not like when you partying. And you having a night that where it seemed like it can't get no better.
You feel me about that wifey though?
Yeah, I know.
That's why I be feeling you. I be like, I know what you're going through, bruh.
Hey, man.
This could have been the best night ever.
So you going to tell them or I'm going to tell them about how my wife called you once she found out my pager's hack? D-Lay laughing. Because in times when shit go bad, D-Lay's been on counselor slash media.
Hey, bro. Simo.
Yeah.
Simo.
Yeah.
Boy. Hey, Courtney, let me just tell you this. Courtney, I know you're watching. It ain't no fun when the rabbit got the gun. it ain't no fun.
Ain't no fun
when the rabbit got the gun. Yeah.
My page is hacked.
Like a motherfucker.
I tell my wife specifically, hey, this person in Russia.
Wait, stop. Because listen, a lot of people was inboxing me. It was like, man, y'all, wow. No, the nigga was really from Russia.
Yeah.
It was really that.
Hey, man.
Real.
Russian hacker in Bulgaria. Because you know, when your shit get broke into your email, it says login, new login from, and I look up.
You get a notification.
I'm looking for Florida, because that's where Courtney is right now. I'm just like, I know this Courtney doing. New login from Bulgaria. I'm like, oh,
Bulgaria,
no.
Bulgaria, you know some.
Oh,
wrong.
No.
Where you at?
No. I'm in California.
You in California?
Yeah, I just landed at the airport.
Ivan Drago. If
he dies, he dies.
Ivan Drago didn't.
Jumped in my fucking email and running amok. This nigga done went in my eBay.
Hey, nigga say Ivan Drago.
Ivan Drago.
Hacked this
fucking in my shit. Yeah, I will break you. This is what he.
I
that's,
must break you.
I must break you. It's like a little piece of metal.
Fight for me. For my family. For my country. I fight. All right, go ahead.
Nigga. So, I'm telling her, I said, man, this hacker's trying to ruin me. He's messaged me on
he's
my-
telling Courtney.
He's messaged me on my fan page, talking about he's gonna ruin my marriage, and he's trying to extort me on some not true shit. At that point, I'm thinking I'm talking to my friend. Like, hey, this is empathy. She don't give a fuck about that. You know what just went off in her head? There's some information that this Russian has that I need. So,
Courtney the Red Sparrow.
Oh my God.
Fucking double agent.
Oh my
you
God.
You fucking working with
Courtney's
the enemy.
Courtney's a double agent.
You working with the fucking enemy.
Courtney's a double agent.
So now, she, yeah, you know, maybe you should go up there to Facebook. Facebook is just a place we just pop up at. But I'm so desperate to get my account back. I'm like, you right. It's a great idea. I'm going to go to Facebook. I call Keyron. Keyron tell me where it's at. I call Nate Jackson. Nate Jackson confirms the address. They give me somebody to go see. Now, I got no appointment. No nothing. Jahan says, what you going to do about getting your account back? I said, no, I'm going up there. Because I need my goddamn Instagram back. This nigga is trying to extort me, Jahan. Jahan says, no, you just can't be showing up there like that. They don't like it when you show up without an appointment. I said, I don't give a fuck. I'm business real. And I got 63,300 followers. They're going to let me the fuck back in.
I got 63,300 followers.
I've been down with this company. I start talking about Instagram like it's an IRA, like I done invested in it. Like I got 30,000
followers. Simo, I got 63,300 followers. I'm Billy Sorrells. Nigga, The Rock got 63 million. Billy said I got 63,000.3.
Man. Keyron got 4 million. I got 1.8. I'm going to fucking Facebook. I don't give a fuck. So they give me the address. I get there. It's a glass door that you gotta have a motherfucking badge to go in. So people just, I see it coming up. I see people hit tapping the badge and walking in.
What you got on?
Oh, I got on my black long coat with the fur around the collar.
Try to see how you looking. If you
I look like I got money. I might be European.
Gotcha.
Or
you don't know what's going on.
Because I got this long coat on because I just come straight from the airport.
Gotcha.
So I see them tap the badge. I walk right in behind them. The next door, there's an in-between door, and then there's another door to go into the actual real lobby. So it's like a holding lobby that's not a real lobby that's got some chairs with a camera and a tablet. And then it's a glass big wall that you see all the inside of their front real lobby. And then about 15 to 20 feet away, it's an actual desk where the people sitting at. They can put a button and you can screen pop up and they can see you and talk face conference with you.
Gotcha.
FaceTime right there. So I'm walking through the next door. I said, I know I ain't got no badge for that. I ain't trying to risk that. Keep walking, keep talking.
That's right.
What you got to do.
Goddamn right.
When you're trying to sneak in the club, you keep walking, keep talking.
Don't you stop.
So boom, I get through the door. I'm right behind this person in front of me. They being oblivious. I'm walking right the fuck in. You don't know who I am, but I'm inside. I got this coat on.
And you look like somebody.
Yeah. Security guard, black dude. He steps out. He hits me. Hey, nah, bruh. Whenever a nigga hits you with that, hey, nah, bruh.
Hey, he know you ain't supposed to be there. Wherever you at, you ain't supposed to be there.
Hey, nah, bruh. And he had to say, nah, bruh. He had to say, excuse me.
He said, nah, bruh.
He said, hey, nah, bruh. Totally against Facebook protocol.
All out of Facebook protocol.
He ain't saying, hey, welcome to Facebook. You know how they greet you like it's a big deal.
Nah, bruh.
Hey, nah, bruh. And that nah, bruh kind of stopped me because he came behind that counter. So I stopped. I wasn't going to give up no leverage and go back out. But I wasn't going to keep going forward to make it weird. So I kind of stopped. Like, yay. He was like, come on, man.
What did he hit you with, man?
Other people coming in, little programmers, little Asian cats coming in, people getting walked in. Welcome to Facebook. Some lady came out the back with a latte. Hey, welcome, guys. Welcome to Facebook. This is our South Campus over here, right in Culver City. He got me across it. Come on, bro. Come on. So I go back outside in the little middle part. He says, man, you got to punch in. I didn't see you punch in. You just walked in. I said, yeah, no. I said, I'm up in here. I'm wilding out. And we got our premiere. My page down. Stuff is happening. I told Nick I was going to come. And then Keyron. So I'm trying to say as many names as possible to tell them with MTV.
Hey, bro. He told the security, nah, I'm up in here. Hey, bro. Hey, bro. You can't tell security, nah, I'm up in here.
Nah, I'm up in here.
And that's your credential.
That's it. That's my credential.
Bro.
Everybody else got badges. They tapping this goddamn thing.
Oh, my God.
Nah, I hit him with it. I said, I'm up in here. I'm up in here, man. Where Justin at? Justin Anthony. Justin, where Justin at? Yeah, because they told me to come and talk to him because I told Nick and Kevin and them.
You dropping all the names.
All the names because the stuff with LOL because we got the cartoon to the project. and MTV the show come out, and my album dropped today. So, and Kieron and them, and then King Batch.
That nigga just, that nigga name dropping anybody he ever spoke to.
You know, because with Jamie Foxx, they told me what I needed to do when I got here to Justin. So, I'm dropping so many names, dude kind of like, he taking it, he tried to take it all in, but he like, all right, he ain't just immediately doubting me. And then he starts kind of, but he ain't moving forward. He's like, well, yeah, man, they gonna punch you right in, bro. Don't even worry about it. Don't even worry about it. They gonna get you where you need to go. I sit there, I'm like, all right. Lady comes on the screen. Hi, welcome to Facebook. Notice you are having a little bit of trouble. Who told you to come in? Who'd you have an appointment with? I said, Justin, you need to talk to him. Management told me to come right over because, you know, we got a breach in our security. We've been hacked, and we got a live stream.
Keep talking!
We got a branded live stream we got to do today that's got to be done for the client that they told us we're doing it. And she says, oh, yeah, okay, a branded. So how many do you have? How many what? What, you know, which program are you in? You in the one for 2 million or 4 million followers? Oh, no, I got 63,300. I'm in that program. So she says, wait, I didn't hear you. You got how many? And so I feel like when she asked me to repeat myself, she put me on speaker so everybody could hear around. Because immediately around her desk, I seen people kind of like lean over. And she's like, she hits the button. How many again? 63,300. And she lets the button off. And then I can't hear what they're saying, but I see their face. So they laughing. You know, they're laughing. They're laughing about how many followers I said. And they all sitting around the FaceTime. So now somebody else comes on. And it's past the intercom time. Hey, welcome to Facebook. So which program of influence are you in? Now, they told me you were King Batch. So you're in tier one, tier two? Are you one of our diamonds? Which one are you? I said, what you mean? Which program? Because, you know, I'm in a special program. Oh, so how many do you have tier one? It's starting at 3 million followers. You in? No, 63,300. Oh, that's exactly what we need to know. Got off that thing. They all talking again, and I swear they laughing at me. So
they damn sure laughing.
At this point, the first lady who's the receptionist, she comes back on. She says, you were here to see Justin? I said, yeah. Well, Justin is out of the country right now with Mr. Zuckerberg doing a project. He's been gone for 2 weeks, and he won't be back for another week and a half. And there's nothing on the schedule to see anybody, or today or tomorrow. I said, what about Monday? No, he's not going to be back for a week and a half. Actually, I have him on Messenger. They're on a flight right now. You want to tell us who set the appointment? So, I don't got no appointment.
No, you don't. So who gives a fuck?
So, I got to just drop all my boys' names. I want to let you know.
Drop.
I'm dropping you.
Drop.
So I started right back off with Key. Yeah, so Kieron. He had
any name that'll stick to their brain.
Yeah, you know, we doing that thing together that we doing.
Right.
So I had to come down here because the branded deal had supposed to went live because it's a stream. And then we had a breach. And then I start using words that white people in technology use because my account had been compromised.
That's a good word.
That fits. Because once it was compromised, there's a lot of viable and sensitive information that's in there.
Data. Throw data in there.
And throw data in there. I didn't say it right then. Data didn't come out. I said, well, the breach of data is what I'm worried about.
You always want to throw data in there.
It's a breach of data is what I'm worried about.
If you throw data in there early, it's established immediate credibility.
And
just the word data. In any conversation, if you just throw data out.
Well, you know, when you talk about the podcast, we look at the data and the analytics.
Come on, man. Who going to argue
you
with that?
You throw out data and analytics, you doing something.
Hey, bruh.
So I'm dropping them words. I'm dropping words, keywords, and names. Yeah, because Nick Cannon, because what we're doing with that is, you know, the show is coming out. And we're dropping that. And, you know, I had told Fox that me being on Kevin Hart's LOL network.
Jamie.
Yeah. Mr. Fox. That coming up here, he said you guys were some good people and y'all was going to help me get through this. So she's, okay. Well, yeah. We don't have any appointments for you. So what we're going to do is... we'll send a iPad out. You can put your complaint in, and you can file it right here about what's going on with your account. I say, well, it's a data breach, actually. It's time sensitive. It's urgent that we stop this breach immediately.
It's urgent. That's a good word.
It's urgent. Okay. So I get in there, I put the stuff in the iPad, I leave, I'm frustrated, I'm mad. I leave out of there, I start driving to the crib. I call Courtney back, say, yeah, I left Facebook. Oh, did you? Now the oh, did you is like,
I get it.
I don't give a fuck what you did. I don't give a fuck if you did or didn't talk to Mark Zuckerberg. You know why? Because I got this Russian hacker on my DMs right now, and he's giving him her all the information, trying to at least. So she drops to me. Well, it's too bad. So that's not you that's messaging me from your account, sending me all these messages? I thought you just wanted to be on a clean slate. Why don't you just tell me what happened? You can go ahead and tell me. It's cool. I'm not going to be mad. I said, I don't even know what you're talking about. I had to hit it with that. Oh, girl, you wild.
Crazy, girl.
You crazy. What you talking about? Yeah, well, so that's not you that's... Oh, so I guess it is legitimate. I thought you were just playing. So, yeah. I guess the hacker is just trying to give me your whole life. I said, why are you talking to him? Why shouldn't I talk to him? Don't you want your page back? Yeah, but no, that ain't how we supposed to do that. I said, you don't negotiate with terrorists. But I can think to say that to say how I'm presidential.
You don't negotiate with terrorists.
She's like, he's not a fucking terrorist, Billy. He's not trying to blow up a building. I said, you don't know what the fuck he gonna do with that page. You don't know what he can do with that information that's in there. Because of the data breach, it's sensitive information in there that could be hurtful to a lot of people. At this point, he's a terrorist. He's a threat to Homeland Security at this point. What are you talking about? I said, first of all, you know that's a charge. Because we at war with Russia right now. We're in a Cold War with them. And you ain't supposed to have no type of contact with Russia at all. You see, that's what the whole shit on the news is about.
We had a Cold War with Russia. You ain't supposed to talk to them.
You ain't supposed to be talking to them over there because of the sensitive. You see what happened with the Facebook with Donald Trump and Putin. We ain't supposed to talk to them right now. That's a federal offense. She said, you can shut the fuck up, Billy. That's what the fuck people do. You shut the fuck up. Matter of fact, fuck you. Hangs up the phone. At this point, I'm panicking. I got to know what the fuck is going on. I'm like, fuck. So I had Courtney's page. So I get in Courtney's page, and I'm scrolling through. Now I'm in her DMs reading the messages from my page. This son of a bitch is trying to tell it all. He got screenshots, all type of shit. Got a medium hard picture of my dick. This ain't the showcase picture. This like the picture you take building up trying to find the right angle.
Right.
He got one of them screenshotted. Is this his penis? Yeah, it is. But anybody could have
done it. The hacker done sent your dick.
My hacker done sent my dick limp back to my wife. So now it's whoever the fuck I'm sending a medium-sized dick picture to, it's personal. Because, you know, you don't just send a picture of your dick out not all the way erect unless you just, you know, y'all know each other. They didn't see you like that before. All
right.
All this inference is what I'm gaining from how this could all get thrown back up. Now, the conversation looked bogus because I don't really talk like that, so I don't really know where this conversation came from. But that damn sure is my dick, and it's damn sure my dick that he didn't send over to her. So she's trying to go back and forth. Now, I want to let you know this hacker is probably by far the worst hacker of all time because he started his negotiation with me with $1,000. Now, I want to tell you a small detail. He messaged me on my fan page while I was at Facebook, saying he wanted this $1,000. I hit him back with a picture of me in front of the Facebook wall logo in front of the monitor saying, hey, God bless you, bro, on your endeavor, man. But I think we're going to have this problem wrapped up in a few minutes because I'm up here at Facebook finna talk to Mark.
Right? Yeah.
Click. Sent that back.
Who you finna talk to?
Finna go talk to Mark. Because I'm a hacker to know.
First name basis.
You know exactly what I'm doing. So,
hey, Simo. This nigga said, I'm up here about to talk to Mark.
So, but see, he don't know if I know Mark or not. That's what I'm thinking.
But just leave it at Mark.
You fucked up. I don't got to threaten you because I got the power. So I look at the message after I get out of Courtney's inbox to my fan page. And he says, oh, you about to talk to Mark? Well, tell him good luck putting your page back together when I delete your shit, especially these little heartbreaking videos of you and your daddy. I said, hey, man.
Whoa.
Hey, man.
This nigga playing dirty.
He playing real dirty. I said,
he
hey, man.
He playing dirty and he using Google Translate.
Yeah, listen.
Because the nigga don't speak English.
It's because, you know, every other word is a little off. His U right. spells Y-O, no U at the end.
Right.
You know, his punctuation is bad. So I know he don't speak English first. I said, man, let me tell you something. God bless you, man. And good luck with your endeavor.
Good, stay poised.
I'm trying to stay poised. I ain't trying to show him that I'm panicking.
Right.
He sends me over a screenshot. Too bad your wife's going to see all these nasty, naughty emails and DMs and pictures you got. The fact that he was nasty, naughty.
Naughty.
it made me feel uncomfortable. He's a pervert. And he's an avid porn watcher, because naughty and nasty is words that they use on porn sites. So I go back to Courtney's page. They done had a conversation again. In 5 minutes, he's negotiated from $1,000. Courtney got him down to $250. In under 45 minutes, my wife is making an international black web transaction in which she's looked up how to pay him, because he don't want to get paid via PayPal or deposit. He wants to get paid in Bitcoin. She said, well, look, in order for me to go get these Bitcoin for you to get this money, I'm going to have to take $300 right off the top so I can get you $250 worth of Bitcoin in your currency right over to you. I got a way to send over. Is this the app that you want me to use to send it? I'm like, how the fuck is she talking cryptocurrency to get some direct messages? So now the motherfucker got the messages, but he got the face scribbled out. I don't remember this message, but I'm tripping because I'm like, it could be me, could not be me. I'm trying to remember if and when I sent this message at all. It looked like a conversation that's hiding heavy between me and somebody, but I don't think it's me because I don't remember this conversation.
Right.
So, that point, she texts me over, fuck you, you nasty bitch, out of nowhere. I'm like, whoa. I hit her on a FaceTime. I said, hey, girl, what's going on with you? Yeah, fuck you, little nasty bitch. I see what the fuck you over there doing. You over there sending your fucking dick out. But it's cool. I'm going to deal with this in a minute. I said, so you just want to go and negotiate with him? Then talk your boy down to 250, huh? Yeah, what's wrong? You scared? You scared? Be scared. Click, hang the phone up. I'm now getting back in my car, leaving Facebook. No account info. I'm hot. My page is down. I've edited all these videos to post to promote the comedy album I put out, Last of My Kind, in the weekend to sell tickets for Dallas. I'm upset because I came to LA with an agenda of working hard. So now I'm distracted. I'm driving back. 10 minutes in, I get a call from D-Lay on the phone. He's dying laughing. But the first few minutes is kind of panicky because he's like, hey, man, she talking to that boy. What is that phone call like when she call you?
Hey, man, I was going to say that for Patreon. I was going to let you finish it and say, you know what? You goddamn right. Get Patreon. Because that's where the fuck that story is going.
After the show,
After the show, baby. Keep going. Keep you going. I'm going to tell you what that conversation is like.
Okay.
I'm glad you asked. Go on and subscribe, people. What better way to go and promote that thing?
Right there. What she said to D-Lay.
Because I promise you want to hear this shit. Because I was sitting back waiting. I was like, I know Simo going to do some, I'm glad you asked, but I'm like, nope. I got some shit for you. Subscribe. Go ahead, Billy.
So I'm driving home. I get there. Now Evans calls me. Now Evans is one of the EPs of Wildin' Out and one of the co-creators of the show with Nick, one of Nick's best friends. Now calls me. Hey, Billy. What the fuck, man? What's going on? What you do? I said, I ain't do nothing now. I just want to get my page back. Yeah, well, you barged up in there saying Nick told you to come up there. I said, I never said Nick Cat told me to come up there. But I did mention Nick's name.
Right.
Because I needed it.
I had to work it.
He said, nigga, I started laughing when I saw your name come up in my email that Billy Sorrells done walked into Facebook. I said, you know what? I got to get credit. You found Facebook and walked in. He said, I ain't been to Facebook yet. Yeah. I said, man, go ahead and tell Nick I'm sorry. He's like, Nick don't know.
All right.
But don't be telling people he had told you to come in there.
Man.
I said, all right, cool. Cool, I ain't tripping. So I get home, I sit down, take a shower. Frustrated. I keep trying to log in, Instagram is gone.
I know you were frustrated because people was texting me saying Billy Pink, because I sent out an alert saying, hey guys, alert Facebook, whoever you need to talk to, Instagram, let's flood them with, hey, hashtag Russians hack Billy.
Right.
So people was like, it's still down. And I'm like, they got to bring it back up. Pint, shout out to Pint, said, hey, listen, I think his page will be reloaded by tomorrow.
Yeah.
I was like, eh, we'll see. But I knew they was getting at me.
So now, kind of sad, look at my email. Email is from 2FAC. I open the email. Hey, thanks for coming into Facebook today. We got your message. We understand that getting back to your page and getting back to being an influencer is a high priority for you.
Goddamn right it's high.
Below is a link to reset your page and roll it back to the status it was before and giving you access back to your page again. Follow the steps. You should be in a minute. Thank you, Ling Huey. Ling Huey, Facebook development staff. So I'm hyped. I hit the link. I'm right back in my page. In the nick of time. Because now, my wife, when I go in and I check her Instagram DM messages, she's talked them down to $40. She has talked this hacker from $1,000 to $40. Now I'm kind of concerned that why are you trying to negotiate with somebody that only wants $40? He's not some powerful man sitting in front of a room with a bunch of laptops. He's in a cave taking in heavy artillery somewhere between Serbia and Uzbekistan, trying not to get killed by an RPG. And he just wants $40 to feed his family. Now I empathize with his brother who went through all this process.
He went through some shit.
Because I am a tech machine. I got two-factor authentication. That's what got me. How did he get past my two-factor authentication of it coming to my phone? I'm up on all this shit. I delete my cash. I don't keep any cookies that nobody can trace me. I'm basically invisible on the black dark web because I go over there quite frequently.
You be over there.
I be over there. I'm inside. I see the messages going back and forth in Courtney's message. So is the $40 good or not? I write back. Yeah, it's good. If you don't want me to drop this. And immediately I go through my phone, go to some very nice videos of Courtney giving me the best head that I've gotten in a long time. It's like all time, top 10 best head moments. I got on video, I screenshot that, sent it over to her, said, maybe I should just start putting this out first on Billy's page. Since you want to negotiate, the price goes back up, $700. And she was like, wait, no. That's what she writes, no. I said, oh yeah.
No.
The rabbit's got the gun.
The rabbit's got the gun.
And immediately I start going through my phone and taking every screenshot of every nasty video that me and my wife got. And I'm screenshotting to send it over for this one. Or maybe I should tag your brother in this one. Or maybe this one. She's like, OMG, come on. You wouldn't. I said, oh, but I would. So now I gotta fuck with Courtney. Courtney was fucking with me. I told her, because she asked me, how the fuck to get a picture of your dick? I said, you know they broke in my phone. And if they go on my phone, they can see everything in my iCloud. And everything in my iCloud got all the pictures. So they definitely just went through there, found a dick. And I mean, ain't no other dicks in the phone but mine.
Right.
So of course it's mine. If it's in my phone, I don't got random other people's dicks in the phone. It's my dick. And I done sent you the same picture of the dick. You didn't send me this one. I said, well, you know what? This is the warm-up going to that. And you know you always take a couple shots before you take the main shot. Mm-hmm. She was like, all right, yeah, whatever, nigga. You sending your dick out to somebody. So you know what? I got to give you some retribution. Message her back again. Say, here, take a little bit of this video. I edited this little freaky-ass little porn, homemade porn we had for about 10 seconds. I sent that over. She's like, I have children. I have a family. Now all of a sudden, you motherfucking Teresa.
Fucking Mary Poppins.
You Mary Poppins. A minute ago, you was ready to be Angelina Jolie, Agent M, Salt, negotiating with Ivan Drago on the black web for my life and secrets. But now all of a sudden, you this stay-at-home soccer mom. Bitch. You finna get it today, because I'm about to drive this price. I said, now the price is back up to $1,100. So she's freaking out. I called Courtney on phone. I said, what's going on, babe? Nothing. What's up? I said, just checking on you. No, I ain't even worried about that page. You know, I'm just glad I got my family and my wife, man. You know, that's what's most important, man. I had a long day. I'm kind of tired. I'm going to take a shower and take a little nap. But, you know, you let me know if you need anything. And I love you and the kids. I said, where the kids at? They're fine. I said, where are they? Can I talk to them? So she gets mad. She turns the phone, the kids in the backseat. I say, hey kids, hey girls, daddy love you. And I see you this weekend when we all get together, daddy loves you. I just want to tell you I love you, okay? Oh, daddy, I miss you, daddy. Oh, it's okay. Daddy, what's wrong? I said, the bad man took daddy's phone and took daddy's stuff. They took your stuff, daddy? I said, yeah, they took my stuff. But it's okay, daddy loves you and I miss y'all. So I said, hey baby, I want to let you know I miss you. Hey, okay, Billy, I'm driving, I gotta go. I jump right back in the messages in my account. I start back messaging again. I said, price done went up to $1,500. Because if he cares about you, he doesn't care about your page, he can go up to $2,000 and give me that. Just $2,000 firm.
And if you don't have it, I'm starting releasing these in 45 minutes. So now she's like, wait, don't. Let me ask somebody. Maybe I can ask my dad. She panicking. And I leave her there. And I said, make it a little bit more interesting. I said, oh, you mean your dad that lives at, I'll give the address. Oh, Stanley Cameron, him, yeah. What about your mom, Donna? What about her? So, and now I'm going through the phone. I'm taking screenshots of family photos and sending them. I said, all of them. Think they'll be proud of you. She just puts a crying face like, please, she got the prayer, please don't do this. I'm nobody. Nobody wants to see those pictures. And you know what? If you want to put videos out of me and my husband, it's my husband anyway. Oh, but the people at your church, Jehovah's Witness.
Oh, yeah. How would they feel about it?
She's like, I don't care. It is what it is. I said, all right. So I FaceTime from Instagram. She answers. I put the phone down on black. I said, do you ready to make a deal? She said, hello? Are you ready to make a deal? Yeah. There's the money. There is the money. I'm trying to get it converted to Bitcoin. And I flip the phone, look right at it, and I look her in the eyes, and she looked me in the eyes, and she saw a surprise, and I say, did you miss me? God damn!
We took you around the world and dropped
your ass off.
Yes, God damn it. Happy New Year's, everybody.
Happy New Year's, everybody.
Thank y'all for bringing it in with us, man.
Thank you for rocking with us another year. I'm Billy Sorrells.
Man, this is Did You Miss Me? Let's do this, bitch. Bigger than the John Gotti did when he beat them charges, bitches.
Hey, man, to everybody out there, wherever you are, we want to let you know we love you. We appreciate you. Thank you for rocking with us, man, getting us through. And we're definitely going to turn up for our milestone this year because definitely happening soon is our 100th episode.
Goddamn right.
So get ready for it, guys. It's going to be extravaganza. Details coming your way.
I'm going to go and plug it right now. You might want to subscribe to Patreon because the story, what Courtney calling me, is on deck, bitches. His own deck. Go and subscribe to Patreon. For as low as $2.